My name is Rahil Philippos and I'm reporting live from the Asian College of Journalism here in Chennai. Today was a particularly significant day here at ACJ as we had some of the country's most prominent voices in the area of environment and conservation coming together to discuss, dissect and interrogate the Kaveri Calling Campaign by Isha Foundation. Now, what is the Kaveri Calling Campaign? It's a campaign initiated by the Isha Foundation to restore the Kaveri water belt by planting an approximate of 2.8 million trees along the riverside. Our seminar today began with a keynote speech by noted economist Mihir Shah, and we have our correspondent Riya Gupta going over the details of his speech.
Hi, my name is Riya Gupta and I'm reporting from ACJ. So at today's event, after Leo Saldana contextualized the seminar, economist Dr. Mihir Shah came in to give his keynote address as to how the paradigm shift in the project is not developed enough and does not go far enough to address how the area was deforested.
We need to understand better what is it that is making the farmers do what they are doing today before we can even try and begin to make a change in what they're doing. I believe a change is required. I do believe a change is required. I'm going to argue what kind of change is required. And I'm also going to suggest the way that change can come about.
That the focus on just planting the trees alongside the Kaveri River is not enough and is a very minuscule detail compared to the wide variety of factors that affect this issue, such as the extractive culture of industries, how there is not much importance given to the techniques that farmers have been employing since old times, I would say. And this has destroyed the catchment area, which has obstructed the flow, which is a much bigger issue at hand.
The first panel at the seminar looked into the hydrological ecosystem dynamics of the Kaveri water belt, and who better to raise these issues than author journalist B. Viju, along with Suprabha Seshan of the Gurukul Botanical Sanctuary in Wayanad, and Dr. Jagdish Krishnaswamy, a senior fellow at the Ashoka Trust for Research in Ecology and Environment.
For the revival of the Kaveri River from the headwaters all the way to the delta, two things that should be added to our discussion here is, of course, the fact that the Kaveri Basin straddles several biomes. Biomes have their, each biome has its own rainfall regime, its own season, its own phenology, its own vegetation type, and so on. So right from evergreen forests to high elevation grasslands, all the way to we have semi-arid biomes in the Kaveri Basin, where you actually have savanna woodlands, you have grasses and shrubs dominating. So that's one aspect of what a true restoration of the ecology, ecosystems, and linked livelihoods of the Kaveri Basin should be addressing is the diversity of biomes.
All panelists focused on sustainable solutions for restoration. They agreed that there had to be a multiplayer approach to restoration, and the only way to do that was to involve the communities that lived along the riverside. No one could provide better solutions than them, which Ms. Suprabha very pertinently pointed out.
Local self-sufficiency, support of each other, taking lands away from chemical-intensive banana farming to make banana chips for some kind of an industry to bring it to people. Why do we need to have banana chips? Why do we need to have sugar that is killing the world? There are so many solutions to this problem, but diversification is inherent in life. You step back and you watch it happen. And I came all along the Kaveri up to Mysore, and I was really impressed by the presence of life through the farming communities outside of the forest. But come the dry season, there's going to be hell over there.
Krishnaswamy also stated that it was very important to have a sediment management system in place, which we further were able to talk to him about after the panel discussion. We were able to interview him and he shared his views on the Isha Foundation's campaign, and it's here for you to check out.
So his plan is to plant trees so that the water goes inside the soil. So what do you think about this, sir, as a plan?
Yeah, I think that agroforestry certainly could be part of the solution, but it's not something that's going to end up putting a a lot of water back into the river, because the scale of the reduction of water flow in the Kaveri is linked to severe exploitation of groundwater used in for agriculture, and also the fact that much of the water is trapped in reservoirs and then diverted for agriculture and other uses. And so there's simply not enough water flowing in the dry season in the Kaveri. Forests at the largest scale in the Western Ghats are linked to sustaining rainfall through recycling of evapotranspiration and so on. That's been shown. But at the scale of 1 kilometer strips along the river, even with the enhanced recharge that you may be able to achieve in some areas, it's very unlikely that you're going to be able to revive the dry season flow of the Kaveri, given the massive reductions in flow from upstream. So you would need to actually have a much larger program that's linked to reducing water use in agriculture, reducing the groundwater mining, and it'll take many years before groundwater can revive.